Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
This is video number 2, where I explain how to take old records from previous tax years and just correct them in the current year so that the tax person has the information they need to file the taxes. In this video, I go through and explain how you can figure out what the debits and credits were or what the accounts were that were affected with the original transaction and what the buddy accounts are to undo these transactions. If you want to see the shortcut or the other way of approaching it, go ahead and refer back to video 1 of this 2-part series. Let's talk about method number 2. This is more time consuming, but there's nothing wrong with it. So we're going to go to our checking account and we're going to discover together 8/31/24, start reconciling. So together you and I are like, oh man, there's this stuff that's uncleared. I want to fix it, but I want to fix it in the current year because I don't want the tax person to see me messing up the records from last year. But like, I don't want to just take the shortcut of throwing it into like some willy-nilly account. Like, I want to go through and carefully undo, you know, pick apart the seams. If you don't sew, that may not make a whole lot of sense, but you want to carefully undo the thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of drill down until I figure out what are the debits and credits of the record that I need to reverse. So I've got this bank deposit, and the bank deposit is a sales receipt and blah, blah. I'm like, okay, cool. Let me click on my customer. When I click on that blue hyperlink, it's going to take me to my sales receipt. Once my sales receipt is open, I can just say, okay, QuickBooks, what I really need to know is the debits and credits. Like, I don't care that this says services here. Like, at this moment in time, where did that show up in QuickBooks land? So I'm going to go to more and then go to transaction journal. So what I can see, the accounts that are affected, I'm like, oh, good. This is a treat. There's undeposited funds is affected, services are affected, and the Department of Revenue, which is taxes, are affected. And I'm like, all right, let me just set that on the shelf for a hot minute. Let's go back to our sales receipt. I end up with multiple tabs because I'm like, I want to double check and make sure that the thing I do undoes the, like, it's just me making sure that I'm not messing anything up. What I really need is, I had a sales receipt, but the money never came in and the sale didn't happen. The opposite of a sales receipt is going to be a refund receipt. So I need to make one of those. If I click on more, it's not an option. I was doing something the other day and it like I could click on more and do credit memos. So I thought, well, maybe. Okay, so sales receipts here. Let's close this. Let's go make our refund receipt. So I'm going to click on plus new, do our refund receipt. So our sales receipt was 123 Main Street. So we'll do the same person here. I'm going to do the refund 1/1/24 because what I know is I like all of my adjustments to be on the same day. So if I ever need to, I can pull a record of all the entries dated for January 1st. And it can be like, okay, here's all the things that I did. The from account. Well, I just need to look at my sales receipt and see where did the money go? Like the fake money. The fake money went into undeposited funds. And it's fake because it never actually went in the bank account. But what I know is that the whole reason I found this is because after undeposited funds, it went into the bank account. So if I go to link deposit and deposit, I'm like, okay, it went into the account called checking reconciled. So I'm going to choose checking reconciled. I don't have a check number because I'm not issuing any money. It's going to be services. And then this is going to be for $10 worth of sales. So $10, oops. I need tax to be selected so that it does the magical calculation for the sales tax. So I'll save. And then here, I'm going to go to transaction journal. It helps if you cross your fingers, especially when sales tax is involved. If this goes haywire, like if the sales tax rates have changed or something, get somebody who loves helping with sales tax. I'll help you reluctantly, but I don't love it. So I'm just looking to make sure, like, everything in the debit column was previously, you know, over here in the credit column. And I'm like, yeah, everything matches. So that this thing that I'm about to do, it's going to undo my sales tax and it's going to undo my income. And then it's going to undo the record in the bank. So I'm feeling good about this. Because I don't trust myself to not mess it up. I have to do this the slowest way possible. And the slowest way possible is to go to the reconciliation screen and just look to make sure when I go to reconcile, will I have a number in the deposit and the withdrawal column? So I have an 1101 here and 1101 here. And I'm like, whew, thank goodness. The next one is an expense for ABC Corp. Let's just click on it so we can see it. This record showed up on the tax return. It was part of the expenses on the tax return. Ah, I clicked on the wrong thing. So I need to have it unshow up. I need to take it away for this year. So it was an expense out of the checking account to the category of advertising. The opposite of the expense is a deposit. So I'm just going to go here and I'm going to make a bank deposit. Earlier, I said take money out of the bank account, and now I say put money in the bank account. Where's the money coming from? It's coming from advertising. This feels funny. So think of it like, what would you do if I bought something from Staples or Home Depot and I took that back? You would make a deposit. You would pick Staples, Home Depot, whatever. And for the category, you would use the same category that you used when I made the purchase in the first place. That's what you're doing here. The only difference is no money ever exchanged hands and it never actually got spent or returned or any of that. But you're just telling QuickBooks like, hey, need to reverse that thing. So all this, yep, we're good. I'll click save and close. Let me close this. This is the moment where I'm like, wait, which tab had my reconciliation screen? And so now I can select both of those. What I've done is I've gone every single line and I've selected the things that were outstanding from the previous year, things that didn't clear the bank and should never have shown up on the tax return. And I've made the opposite so that it shows up this year as a negative amount. I'm dating it for 1-1 so that I can tell the tax person like, hey, here's a list of the things that I did. You know, maybe make some notes in the memo where I didn't, but you could. And just say like I was reversing the stuff. You can always, when you get done, you can finish your reconciliation. You've got your reconciliation report. You can save this and be like, this is me just making a correction, or here's a list of my corrections. Like whatever makes you happy. So I just wanted to show you two ways of approaching it. What I do not want you to do is to go mess up the records as they appeared for the tax person last year, year before, whatever. That tax person, they have a tax return that says, here's the total of the income and here's the total of the expenses and here's the breakdown of all the stuff. And if you start willy-nilly deleting things, it's going to make it so that the QuickBooks records don't match the tax records. That's going to mean when the tax person goes to file the taxes, they might spend time and client money trying to figure out, like, why is this stuff not matching? Like, what happened? And then to discover what it was. Like, that's very unnecessary. You just please don't. The tax person can give you different advice. They can say, yeah, I don't care. No problem. You know, totally fine. But as a rule of thumb for just a generic YouTube video, my recommendation is you make the changes in the current year, put some notes, and then just let whoever's in charge of the taxes know, like, hey, it was a little snafu last year. This is what I did for this year. If you want, you can total it all up and like move it around. But like, I have really good notes and here's what I got for you. All right, that's it for explanation number two. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to let me know. If you have ideas for videos that you'd like to see me put together, please don't hesitate to let me know. Thanks.